See, on this car here in the Passat, I'm looking at this because it doesn't run well in the colder mornings. The mass airflow, I've got 8.5, or that was just come down from 10. But that's a tick over, it was 8.5 now. With the ignition on, and the car's just stalled, it's 9.2. Right, so, this engine's not even running. When it warms up, when it warms up, that goes down to about 3. So, wait for it to start reading there. So it is updating. So there's what I want to address there. It's no fault code. The fault code is saying it's running clean. But after a few, by the time I get to the end of the street, that's okay. Also, I'm noticing here the grams per second's changing. This is after I've got to work. That's changing all the time. The throttle position's staying pretty still. Sometimes it does open, and I think it's controlling itself just to help it run. So I'm definitely looking at something with the mass airflow sensor, I think. Throttle position should be at 0 now. If I pick this up, pick up the revs a bit. See there, I'm now at 2.3. Try and hold it up there. About 5%. 6 grams per second, but as soon as I let it go, it's actually cut out and stalled. This time the mass airflow has gone to 0. Anyway, I gotta go into work. I just can't get it to tick over, so I'm now gonna put this back on. Right here. And switch it on again. Why am I not getting that? Yeah. That's a bus going past. Back onto the 1.5 volts. 1.5 coming out of this sensor, but really it's coming out of here. So I'm gonna unplug it. Hey. So I'll push it in to pull it off. There. Okay. 1.5. It won't tick over at all. If I put the sensor simulator on at 1.5, it'll run. Didn't run very well, but it'll run. Right. Plug that in. Obviously it's getting additional voltage that it shouldn't have. I think that's the proof of what's wrong with it though. There we go. Oh, it almost ran. I think that's it. That's enough proof. If I give that 1.5 volts, it ticks over. 1.5, which is here on this wire coming out of that. Put it onto this. Now it should tick over. There's another car coming. Obviously this is only for tick over sort of voltage. It's not for all ranges, but it runs like this. Thank you. stencils saying 5 grams per second. It's just happier that voltage. If I change it slightly, 1.6, put it back a bit, because the multimeter times out just when I do it. 1.3, it's also happy. 1.3, it thinks it's 4 grams per second, which is probably about right. I think that's enough proof that using this, instead of buying a mass airflow sensor, I'm using this, because that's actually disconnected there, you see? It's not plugged in, it's just resting on it. 1.3 volts, it thinks it's at 4 grams per second at tickover, and it's happy. That's like trying a mass airflow sensor without buying one. So I'll go and buy one, see how I get on. Anyway, thought I'd show you this. I've never done some product that's useful and cheap. Okay, this is the short-term fuel trims next morning with a cold engine. Long-term 13, short-term minus 22. So it's taking away more fuel than it's expecting. So if I raise the revs, it's taking away 18, 19, 32. Right, okay, it doesn't show any signs of a vacuum leak. The vacuum leaks would be adding a lot of fuel, not taking it away. But if I take the minus 15 from the 13, you're right about close to zero anyway. That's a 2000 RPM. If I let it tick over, it's staying about the same. So in this case, I'm not too concerned about, not doing too well at getting that top one in focus, short term. See, it's still minus 22, and the long term is plus 13. So it's still taking more fuel away. If this was a car with, there we go, it's cut out again. That's taking nothing away. It takes a while to start refreshing this. There. Now it's taking nothing away. There. Okay. Yeah, I think I'm safe to say it's not got a vacuum leak. But I could smoke test it just to be sure. Okay, I've changed the mass airflow sensor and the car's now working fine. It did get worse before I changed it and it was cutting out. Every time I stopped at a junction, it was cutting out. But the car's fine now, so I thought I'd show you some readings of what it looks like, the voltage at the mass airflow sensor, in case anybody wants to check their own. And what the grams per second are now that it's working. I'm just setting up the scan tool so that I can, I'm pressing the wrong buttons here. Okay, I'll set up the scan tool and just put the voltmeter and the scan tool next to each other and see what happens, see what the difference is. I'm only interested in the mass airflow. I'll not bring up the other things. There it is. Okay, so I'm gonna start with the ignition on, just the ignition. Okay, key on. Okay, that stays at zero. Start the car, 1.2 to 1.4 is the kind of range. Let's tick over. 2.5 grams per second. So that's what I should have. The car is warm though. I've driven all the way back. Now I'm going to hold it at 2000 RPM. approximately. Now I've got like 1.5. And 6 grams per second. I'll do a quick blip. I'll just let the throttle go all the way back down and then just slow down to 1.2 for takeover. 1.1. Right. I was off limit. I should have thought about that. I need to change my range. Yeah. Okay. Change the range now. Let's see what happens. Let me do the min-max again. There's that one. That one. Right. Now I should get it better. So it was up to 3.1 volts. Okay. With a blip. Grams 2.5. I quickly went up to 60, I think I've seen there. So, just to give you an example of what's happening, engine on idling 1.2. I'll probably switch it off. Unlike other sensors that I've checked, some of ones have a voltage with the ignition on, this one doesn't. But as soon as you start it, it does have a voltage. That might help. That might be of some help to somebody. Anyway, so the car wasn't running and it was down to a mass airflow sensor. Thanks for watching.